Vale.
¡Hola!
¡Hola!
Bienvenidos a Lightspeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
Today we have a suggestion from Calvin Thomas. Hola, Calvin.
Oh, Calvin.
Calvin, nice name, eh?
Como Calvin. Maybe it's Calvin.
No, Calvin.
Are you sure? Because sometimes you don't...
Este es su email. Calvin.
Yeah, but sometimes...
Mira, email.
Yes.
Calvin.
But in some countries, the W is a V, like Calvin.
No sé.
Pero... Oh, Calvin. Calvin. Because sometimes a W, you don't pronounce a W in English sometimes. And it's like...
What do you mean you don't pronounce a W in English?
Sometimes you don't. I can't think of the word now.
I should think not.
But sometimes you don't in weird... In
casting
weird.
Aspersions on
it
our
It could
W's.
Be Calvin. It could be Calvin or Calvin. But Calvin is cool as well. Calvin. It's different.
Yo voy a decir Calvin. Porque vale. Se pone dos veces. Calvin. Entonces vamos a ver.
Okay.
Vamos a ver.
¿Es Calvin o es Calvin?
Luego nos orices,
¿vale? En los
¿vale?
comentarios.
Sí. Ok.
Just call him Thomas.
Calvin dice, buenos días a ustedes.
Oh, ya empezamos, ¿eh?
Ustedes, ya.
Pero ustedes.
Tengo un problema un poco raro. ¿Vale?
Vale.
¿Me pueden explicar cómo... ¿Cómo y lo que él...? A ver, vamos a...
A ver, un momento, déjame a mí.
Está preguntando por el lo en lo que...
¿Me pueden explicar cómo y lo que en lo...? ¿Eh? Vale, ya me he liado yo. ¿Me puede explicar cómo...?
See, she was going to do it. She can do it better than I.
No,
and she fell in, at the same hurdle.
How
she fell
what?
At the same hurdle.
How and what?
Which is, there's a slight error in the the structure.
Es que it finishes there, then there's another line, and I was like, okay, I'm thrown now. Lo que el lo funciona en esta frase. Sabía que era lo realmente importante. Okay, so the use of lo.
The use of
in that
and
in
this
that
is advanced intermediate, so we're doing the whole lesson in Spanish. Okay,
ooh,
entonces
okay.
Nos vemos en la segunda parte.
El uso del lo, vale, lo Ajá. importante. Esto es. Es fácil, venga. Es fácil y está muy bien hacerlo porque se usa muchísimo, muchísimo en español. Y es esto de lo importante, lo difícil, lo interesante es que, lo,
sí.
lo bueno es que, lo malo es que, lo fantástico es que,
sí.
lo raro es que.
Sí. No, y... Lo que pasa en esa frase, han puesto un adverbio entre lo importante, ¿no?
Vale, sí.
Y han puesto realmente.
Realmente.
Que confunde la cosa un poco.
Vale, pero realmente lo podemos añadir y lo podemos quitar.
Sí. Ajá.
Lo importante, ¿vale?
Lo importante.
Lo importante, lo realmente importante, lo verdaderamente importante. Puedes añadir un adverbio.
Sí.
Pero realmente estamos hablando de lo importante, lo difícil, lo fácil, lo bueno, lo malo,
lo curioso.
Lo curioso
lo
es que.
Fabuloso,
lo raro
lo...
es que. ¿Vale?
Sí.
Y en inglés se podría traducir como the good thing is, the
sí.
important thing is, the weird thing is, the interesting thing is. Es como.
Sí.
Lo es como en inglés el thing.
Thing.
The good thing is, lo bueno es que bueno, no decimos la palabra cosa.
Claro.
Ponemos lo en vez de thing.
Sí. Entonces, lo thing, pero no quiere decir que lo sea thing en todo el español.
No. Estamos hablando
solamente
de
solamente en esta frase.
En estas frases, en inglés, decís the important thing is y en español decimos lo importante es bla bla bla. Puedes meter un adverbio si quieres, como en inglés. The truly important thing is.
Mm-hmm.
pero truly no es necesario, puedes
no.
meter truly y sacarlo. O the most important thing is, the important thing is, pero uh-huh. the thing is, the important thing is.
Sí.
Lo importante, lo bueno, lo malo.
Sí. Entonces, y, en esas frases piensas en thing, pero ojo, ojo,
ojo.
Esa estructura también puede ser un detonante para el subjuntivo si sigues con qué, ¿no? Lo importante es que aprendan.
Exacto.
¿Sí?
Sí.
Entonces, si dices lo... ¿cómo es? ¿Qué tipo de,
importante?
De, sí, pero importante, ¿qué tipo de palabra es?
Es adjetivo, un adjetivo.
¿Vale? Lo adjetivo. Sí, sí, muy bien, Cintia. Muy bien. Por decírmelo. Luego, es que... Ya, es un detonante. Tienes que usar el subjuntivo.
Eso es.
Pero solamente con qué. Si no, lo importante es aprender rápidamente.
Lo importante es aprender. The important thing is to learn.
Sí.
Pero si ya metemos la estructura con qué, the important thing is that you learn at your pace, for example. Lo importante es que... Now, trigger.
Detonante.
Es que aprendas, you learn, aprendas a tu ritmo, at your own pace. ¿Sí?
Sí. Sí, ajá. Entonces, ¿quieres practicarlo un poco? ¿Hacer unos ejemplos?
¿Qué es eso? ¿Qué?
Venga, venga.
¿Es una cita?
Cintia, en mi opinión, lo importante es ser feliz.
Vale.
¿Estás de acuerdo?
Sí, lo importante es ser feliz. Iba a decir envejecer bien. Envejecer bien, o sea, ser joven mucho tiempo, de espíritu, de mente y de cuerpo.
Vale, dice alguien 20 años mi menor, ¿no?
20 años y más. Bueno, no, 19, no 20, 20. 18, 18 y medio, nada más.
Sí.
Vale. Lo interesante es que estamos en noviembre y hace un poco de calor.
¿Sí? ¿Por qué tengo frío entonces? Si hace calor.
Oh, pero una cosa, esa frase no tiene detonante. O sea, no, perdón, no tiene subjuntivo.
Dímelo otra vez.
Lo interesante es que estamos en noviembre y, no, y hace calor. Bueno, hace calor. Estoy exagerando un poco.
Mm. Ah, pues es opcional, ¿no?
¿Y qué diferencia hay entre es que estemos en noviembre?
Lo importante es que...
No, lo interesante.
Lo interesante
creo que es eso
que...
Lo interesante. O lo raro. Lo raro es lo que... Raro o lo curioso. Es que... Da igual.
Uh-huh.
Es que estamos... ahí quizá podríamos hacer un detonante o no, porque es algo, es un hecho. Estamos en noviembre.
Sí. Ah. ¿Y cómo suena? Lo raro es que estemos en noviembre.
Suena bien también. Ajá. Lo raro es que estemos en noviembre y que haga calor.
Sí. Es la diferencia
sí,
entre
también.
The strange thing is that we are, or the strange thing is that we might be.
Es que en inglés no sería we might be.
No.
No puedes decir we might be. En los dos sería we are. Simplemente uno va con detonante.
Sí.
Pero uno sería como más factual, ¿no? Estamos en noviembre.
Sí.
No sabría por qué sería subjuntivo o no.
Es que creo que es el énfasis, ¿no? Estamos...
Quizá para darle más énfasis a estamos en noviembre.
Sí. Ajá. En mi opinión, es mejor con esa estructura usar el subjuntivo.
Sí,
y
es
no
mejor.
Tener que pensar en, estoy
sí.
hablando de un hecho. O...
Sí, porque es en estructuras específicas, ¿vale? Porque
ajá.
generalmente sería subjuntivo. Por ejemplo, Es muy interesante que hable inglés. No diríamos sí. Es muy interesante que habla inglés. ¿Vale? O es importante. Perdón, lo importante es que termines la carrera. The important thing is that you finish your degree. But when I say those things, you haven't finished the degree. I'm just telling you what's important. So that will be the difference with that one, that I'm saying it's November now. We are in November.
Sí, es más. Sí.
Entonces podría ser las dos, subjuntivo o indicativo. Pero en caso de duda, en ese tipo de frases, subjuntivo.
Subjuntivo.
Y acertarás sí. Seguro.
Sí, sí, sí. Es el subjuntivo, el 95% del subjuntivo está bien, es fácil de seguir, ¿no? Las sí. normas son fáciles. Y luego hay un 5% de curiosidades. Sí.
Luego están las cosas extrañas del subjuntivo. Pero no, me gusta que salgan dudas así porque luego pueden salir claro. y así las hemos cubierto.
Claro, pues eso es todo. Entonces, Calvin, muchas gracias Thomas. Por la sugerencia. Entonces, es thing. Thing, nada más. Lo thing.
The thing.
The thing. Vale, muy bien. And now, a short word from our sponsor.
Go on then.
So we have now, on our website, we have 160 help sheets available that go with all of the video casts that we've done, the first 1 to 40 in each level. Okay, so we've got beginners, early, intermediate, advanced. Every one of those podcasts has a help sheet that goes with it. That really expands on what we've been talking about, because the video casts are only 10 minutes, 15 minutes long. So that the help sheet explains everything. So if you like the content that we cover, especially in the early stuff, then you can get the help sheets that will really help to build up your Spanish as well, okay? We haven't done any help sheets for the new range, which is from 41 onwards. Two reasons why we haven't done that. One is it's a massive amount of work. It's massive. And the other one is really what we've done in the first half is there are three reasons. What we've done in the first half
adding reasons
covers,
to it.
Yeah, covers all that you really need to know. However, the third reason is that Cynthia has told me that she's not going to make any more on pain of death. She said to me, if you make me do any more help sheets, I'm going to kill you. All right, not on her death, no. On my death.
Explain why.
I don't
why.
Know why. It's just
because
what you
I
said.
I did 10 and then I sent them to him. And when he was ready to work on them, he said, I've lost them all. And I had to do them again. So I've actually worked harder.
Cynthia did a lot. I mean, we split them in half.
So
I was doing the beginners and the early intermediate. Cynthia was doing the advanced and the advanced and the medium. And yeah, the harder ones. The better level ones. Vamos a decirlo, ¿no? Claramente. Ella porque es española y súper inteligente.
No, it's not that. But then you lose them.
Then I lost them, yeah. But Cynthia was pregnant at the time.
Yeah.
Heavily pregnant.
And he lost
heavily.
Them.
And we didn't know whether we were going to get them finished before Sebastian came. It was like, come on. And yeah. We were working till like 11 o'clock at night. And 11 o'clock at night, Cynthia sent me them and she said, oh, I've sent you them. And I said, I've lost them. I think I can't remember quite what happened, but you had already deleted them or something like that.
I don't know. I think maybe I deleted them or I changed my computer or something.
Something, yeah. Yeah.
Anyway.
I could kill so Gordon. They're available. Look, they're there. They'll give you a really nice compliment to your learning. Anyway,
yes.
Okay? Pues eso es todo, chicos. Ahora.
But before we go, do you remember that Gordon said previously in this video, you can rewind, he said, we always pronounce the W. And I said, sometimes you don't. And he said, you're a liar.
I can't recall using that kind of language.
Because sometimes a W, you don't pronounce a W in English sometimes. And he's like,
What do you mean you don't pronounce the W in English?
Sometimes you don't. I can't think of the word now.
I should think not.
You liar. We always... English is a very well-structured language. I can't recall exactly what you said.
Absolutely.
And we would never miss out the W. Okay?
No, you said that sometimes you pronounce a W as a V. That's what you said.
In some other countries, I said. Like you said, in Germany.
Yeah, oh, absolutely. And the Hindus...
Yeah,
absolutely.
That's what I said. You know, you can rewind. I said in other places they.
Honey, we don't rewind anymore. Rewind is the old for the bobbin. The bobbin.
Well, part, I'm from the 90s, so I still rewind.
Go back.
But
all right.
How do you say it, Gordon? You can write the word down.
Okay.
How do you say?
How do we say this word? But if the Americans are watching, they won't know.
Why?
They'll say Greenwich.
Do you?
They, okay. Because they don't know. They don't
because
know.
Because they don't know.
They don't know because they've probably got a town called Greenwich over there. They've got all the names of the UK. But in the UK, we say Greenwich. So there's no W. So in that, you're right. In that one example. Once more. Te doy la razón. Okay, and if you want to, you can hear the conversation that we had about this off camera.
No, you don't have to at the
end,
conversation.
In a little outtake.
Because I had some other
And you'll
words.
See lo mala que es conmigo. Dura, ¿eh? Yo tengo que vivir con esta.
I want to know if it's true that American people and Canadians and well, from the US... Because you don't have a word like estadounidense.
No.
You have to say American.
American.
But then you have to say Canadian, even though they are Americans as well. Because Americans is
I'm not entirely sure that the Canadian people would be very happy about you saying that they're Americans.
Are they not?
No, they're Canadians.
It's they're because, an American.
Yeah, because you refer to the continent.
Right, no, I don't refer to the
continent. Yes, you do. You
American,
refer to-
right. People from the US call themselves Americans.
That's right.
And people from Canada are Canadians.
Canadians
I know that.
Yeah.
But they're also American because they're in the... It's like saying European. You know what
right.
I mean?
Right. If you're referring to the continent, yes. But Canadians like to refer to themselves as Canadian, I think.
Yes. Okay. So what I mean, people from North America...
Yes.
With, including... Canada and Alaska.
And Alaska, yeah.
Am I missing anything there?
I'm not entirely sure, but there you are.
Do you say... Well, Alaska is also part of the US, no?
US, yeah.
Anyway, do you say Greenwich or
Greenwich.
Right.
We say Greenwich Mean Time.
Greenwich or why Gren? It should be green.
I know, Greenwich. But just the way that we say it. I'm telling you that if they don't know that it's Greenwich, they'll say Greenwich.
Why on earth?
Everybody in the entire English-speaking world that doesn't know that word would say Greenwich.
I would say Greenwich.
Absolutely, and rightly so.
Yeah.
But it's Greenwich.
Because we decided...
and because
we can do whatever we
want. That's how we said it from the beginning. When they actually put the timeline there, the Greenwich timeline, the meridian, that all time starts from Greenwich.
It's like this.
Is it? Okay, that.
Yeah, all time latitude.
All time starts from Greenwich. If Greenwich didn't exist, we time wouldn't mean anything. We go, what time? I don't know. Because Greenwich didn't exist. Were it not for Greenwich. And that's why...
Gracias, Greenwich.
Todo mi respeto, we have to say Greenwich and not Greenwich, okay? Because that's its name. Bueno. Okay. Pues eso es todo.
Muy bien.
Y nos vamos.
Y nos vemos. Adiós. How do you pronounce that?
Baldwin.
Yeah, you don't say Baldwin.
Baldwin?
Sounds like Baldwin.
Duin.
No, win.
Duin. Baldwin.
Vale,
Baldwin. Baldwin.
No, Baldwin. Hace cosas así con eso.
Okay.
Sandwich.
Dwitch. Sandwich. Sandwich.
Yeah.
Sandwich.
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 ¿No?
Mm-hmm.
¿Sí o no?
Sandwich.
Sandwich. Sandwich. No.
Sandwich.
Sandwich. Es lo mismo que si pone una U.
Dwitch. Okay, okay.
¿Sí o no?
Dwitch.
¿Sí o no? Di que sí, di que sí, di
there's
que
a,
sí.
There's an U sound because we've got to go from the dirt to the W without with, make it. We've got to make it sound nice.
Pues ya okay. Está. Entonces, a veces okay. No pronunciáis la W, pronunciáis una U. Admítelo, Gordor, admite joder, que...
Joder, joder, qué paciencia, qué paciencia.
Vale, venga.
So, we have levels, beginners.
Ajá.
Greenwich. Ah.
¡Ja! ¡Toma ya, toma ya! Greenwich.
Ok, ok.
Es que me encanta cuando gano. Vale, ahora vamos a hacer el vídeo y lo voy a decir, ¿eh? Después de cortar.
Paciencia.
No.
Otra vez, empiezo
esto,
con
esto lo cortas y después te voy a decir que digas esta okay. Palabra, ¿vale?